साथियों, मैं देश के 125 करोड़ देशवासियों को मुंबई अहमदाबाद हाई स्पीड रेल कॉरिडोर का इस भूमि पूजन के अवसर पर कोटि कोटि शुभकामनाएं और बधाइयां देता हूं।
A developing country like India needs adequate infrastructure, advanced technology, and land. Yet we also cannot live without our forests. We are already witnessing climate change across the world at an alarming rate. Today we will see the debate between technology and environment, the implications on mangrove forests, Land Acquisition Act dealing with rehabilitation of people, and the benefits of the train.
Over 32,044 mangrove trees will be cut, which will affect 11 species of mangroves and 177 species of resident and migratory birds. Does the government take nature seriously? Fishermen will lose their homes and livelihood. How will you compensate them?
The numbers that the people throw out, they look like any other number, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. To give you an idea, if you see Azad Maidan, which everybody in Mumbai is aware about, of it, 30,000 mangroves will be almost 3-4 Azad Maidans in that level of, you know, mangroves that were destroyed, which I think is just being criminal.
The Indian government is planning to maybe cut down 30 to 35,000 or maybe more trees, but they are going to be planting 5 times more in future after the work is going to be finished. So there's no chance of any harm to be done.
So my complaint was sent to the environment department, and it has come back to me saying that every desk is saying it is not a concern there. It's not there, not they have nothing to do with it. I was perturbed. I said, environment destruction, if environment department is not concerned with it, who else is concerned?
Do you seriously think government doesn't make things work? 7 kilometers of the bullet train will be underwater to avoid damage to the environment. Bullet train will facilitate high-speed connect using electric power, reducing carbon emissions.
As far as my knowledge goes, it's only the Shiv Sena, my party, who is very aggressive about the environmental issues. The CM of Maharashtra, Honorable Uddhavji Thackeray, has decided to take a review of all the projects. Another thing is that cutting a line of tree is different for road widening. But when you chop down a part of the forest, because a forest is not only just trees, but it's an ecosystem. There are n number of species of birds, animals, flora, fauna, everything. So the whole habitat is destroyed.
There are huge chunks of marshy lands which are available in our adjacent area of the coastal belt of western coast. And such marshy lands which have some plantation, mangrove plantation, we can plant more mangroves on these marshy lands, and that is the government's outlook.
If they are talking about mangroves, they should have first asked their own person from Mirabai, Narendra Mehta, the ex-MLA. This time he lost. His own sports complex is on that. I think his clubhouse or something like that, which he has constructed. I mean, why the BJP has not taken action on their own person?
We are tired of all the fake promises government makes. Even if new mangrove trees are planted, it will take at least 10 years for them to grow fully. The sheer level of destruction needed for this train is just not worth it.
Government always attempts to fulfill promises. 273 trees have already been planted. Our government already has a conservation management plan ready to ensure minimal harm to the people and the environment alike. For your kind information, there are many existing laws to protect the environment.
So while taking up any infrastructure project, we have many environmental laws under which the government has to take some precautions. So currently we have the Environmental Protection Act. We have the notifications notifying certain areas as coastal regulation zones. Then we have, when the project is taken up and it is into some wildlife sensitive area, then the government has to acquire or has to take clearance from the Wildlife Protection Board as well. So in case of bullet train also, they had to do all these procedures under various environmental laws in our country.
Minimum 70% of consent is required to acquire land. Government has already acquired 40% of land and it aims to acquire 100% by the end of year 2020. The landowners will get fair compensation for the same.
Are you seriously talking about consent? Farmers are helpless and are being forced to beg for the rightful compensation before the Supreme Court, just to fulfill the government's selfish needs.
About the relevance of land acquisition laws to the bullet train, whenever any government takes up some infrastructure project, they need land for it. In case of bullet train also, that's the case. They need land for this bullet train project. So where does the government get their land from? The land can either be private land or the land owned by government. So when the land is owned by private individuals, government has to acquire the land through an elaborate procedure. Collector finalizes the award and the compensation for land acquisition. After such compensation is finalized, the people can then go to Supreme Courts and High Courts in writ if they find that the compensation is not fair or is not enough. And then the Supreme Court and High Court decide whether the procedure is according to the law and whether the compensation is fair or not.
The people from Palghar district or Thane district or Raigarh district, they had experienced such things in past. Government has acquired the land. Government has acquired the land for Tarapur nuclear power station. Government acquired the land for Surya irrigation project. Government acquired the land for highways. Government acquired the land for railways. But earlier governments didn't take care of these acquisitions and they couldn't get their money, they couldn't get their compensation. They are not rehabilitated properly. Last 3 years, I was heading the Rehabilitation Authority of Maharashtra. And I had discussions with these people. I had meetings with these people. I understand their problems because I am working for the rehabilitation of displaced in Maharashtra for last 10-15 years. And I understand their problems thoroughly.
लोग हमेशा बोलते हैं, भारत बाकी देशों के मुकाबले पीछे है. But when the government tries to develop the country, the people become its worst enemies. Government just asks for some cooperation in return.
Lands for agriculture are being wrongfully used in the name of development. The plans are brilliant on paper, but when it comes to execution, everyone knows how the government operates.
Like 1/4 of the project is going to be in Mumbai, in Maharashtra, and remaining 3/4 of its route, that is in Ahmedabad. But the entire facilities are going to be provided by Maharashtra government. Whenever a project comes up, people lose their land. It may be a fertile land, it may be an unfertile land. But the route from which the bullet train is going is the orchards, the fields of Palghar and all such places where people are going to lose their orchards. There are chiku plantations over there, guavas and such mango orchards also. When today we talk of strengthening agriculture and agricultural produce, and the rice fields, the orchards and other type of farming that people are already doing. Like, it's not that the soil was unfertile and okay, even the farmers said okay, we don't mind giving it away for a public cause. So when people are going to lose their livelihood, okay, you compensate them heavily, but people do need work. It's not that people just need money. People need to be occupied. And then you are going to give them jobs as what?
The government has promised and has assured to give the farmers the market value of the land, which might be taken up. That is if it is.
Now we have introduced a policy of the one-time settlement, which is very higher, which is very profitable to the landowner, which is very profitable to the farmer. And we are taking care of the landless laborer also. Those who are dependent on that land, they might not be owning the land.
You know what? You talk about cooperating with the government for the sake of development. But why should we cooperate when so much has to be sacrificed for nothing?
This train will use Japan's railway's Shinkansen E5 series, which will make our infrastructure world class. This itself will be a big boost to tourism, not to mention the creation of more than 20,000 job opportunities.
Regarding the bullet train, one more important thing is its fare. Like, what would be the cost of traveling? I mean, if the planes are going to be cheaper than the bullet train, which businessman would travel by a bullet train? And if you survey the entire world, except for Japan, bullet trains are nowhere. So it's not that they are very much into vogue and like most used means of commodity. It's not like that.
Even if the prices are the same as the airplane and the bullet train, drawback of the flights would be that when I have to board a flight, I have to at least leave 3 hours before the time. At least 2 hours before my flight, I have to reach check-in and the boarding pass and all that, whatever. So that is a headache for me if you go to sea. I have to plan 3 hours before and 3 hours after. Even if I have to do some shopping, I have to say, oh, I have to catch a flight. Now I can't board the flight. But if it's a bullet train, there's no check-in or there's no check-out, there's no boarding or anything. So I can easily board it at the time the bullet train is going to arrive at the particular station. So that is very important. It will be stopping at different stations. The air flights will not stop at different stations. So that is one major thing.
I am sure you will be the first in line to avail of the improved economy. Not only that, it will promote localization as well. And my dear, when you receive such high-end services, of course you have to pay a price. But the service received more than compensates for the price paid. Recently, 6 more routes have been discussed by the Railway Ministry.
If I want to travel to Ahmedabad, I would rather use Tejas Express. So why on earth should people take bullet train at a cost which most people cannot afford, when so many better options are available?
The diamond market has already started in Surat. It may expand to other parts of Gujarat too, though it's not very full-fledgedly expanded. But yes, for those people who have to travel to and fro, for them it would definitely cut down the time. Next is about the job opportunities. Definitely it will make a lot of difference. A lot of people will definitely have a lot of benefit. A lot of prospects would open up. And definitely India would definitely show its progress. That's for sure.
The employability factor is also there. I also heard that it would be completely run by the Japanese company. So whether the locals will get jobs in it. So there are so many questions which are unanswered in the economic point of view, the environment point of view, the employability point of view. So I think this whole concept of bullet train, according to me, should be completely scrapped off.
High-speed rail corridor was mentioned in the Union Budget 2020.
More Tejas type trains, will connect iconic tourist destinations. High-speed train between Mumbai and Ahmedabad would be actively pursued.
To enhance and sustain life in this millennium, we need technology. For technology to be optimized and utilized for what it is worth, it needs to sustain life, not annihilate. To sustain life, one needs to be in cohesion with the environment. Technology or environment, to create the right balance is in your hands. Life will only sustain as long as there is sustainable development.
Yatrigan, kripya dhyan dijiye. Passengers, please pay attention. On January 2014, several meetings between Japan International Cooperation Agency and Indian Railways proposed to originate the Bandra-Kurla Complex Corridor and Mumbai. On May 2014, project was approved by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. On January 2016, Ministry of Railways set up a special purpose vehicle called National High Speed Rail Corporation Limited. On January 2017, survey work on the route began. The agency completed soil testing at a total of 250 locations by 24 February. On January 2018, Japan and India signed an agreement to establish High-Speed Railway Training Institute in India by 2020. On January 2019, project recovered clearance from the National Board of Wildlife to carry out construction.